Good morning, everyone. I'm Dhruvil Goda, and with me is my colleague,
Dhwani Malviya.
We are here from the Admissions Team of SCIT, Symbiosis Center for Information Technology. We are conducting this webinar today in order to clear all your doubts regarding the SNAP exam, admissions in SCIT, and the various specializations offered at SCIT. So now we'll start taking all your queries one by one.
So our first query is from Rahul. When will be the SNAP 2016 test conducted? Hello Rahul, the SNAP 2016 test will be conducted on 18 December from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in 32 cities approximately. And our second question is from Sanjita. How to register for SNAP 2016 test? Hello Sanjita, you have to register online on the website snaptest.org from August 22nd to November 22nd, 2016. While filling the form, you have to upload your passport size photograph and ensure that your information is filled accurate. Payment has to be made completely and the registration process using the payment gateway of your own choice.
Okay, the next question is, what is the test structure for SNAP 2016? There will be 40 questions on general English, which include reading comprehensions and verbal reasoning. 30 questions on quantitative data interpretation and data sufficiency. 40 questions will be on current affairs. 40 questions on analytical and logical reasoning. The next question is, will there be negative marking in the test? Yes, every wrong answer will include 25% negative marks.
Our next question is from Rishika. Topics that are asked in quantitative analysis in SNAP. Hello Rishika. There'll be questions from geometry, ratio and proportions, percentages, inequalities, quadratic and linear equations, profit and loss, average, time, speed and distance, work and time, number system, permutations and combinations and probability and various quantitative topics. Second question is from Gayatri. What should be the strategy for attempting SNAP? Hello Gayatri, your main focus should be on attempting SNAP would be on speed and accuracy basically.
The next question is from Dheeraj. How will the final shortlist be calculated? The final merit will be calculated after giving different weightage to different scores. The SNAP score, which is out of 150, will be scaled down to 50. Personal interview will be 30 marks. Group exercise will be 10 marks. Written ability test, which will be 10 marks. So total will be 100 marks.
Okay.
The next question is from Raikan. What is the difficulty level in the SNAP test? SNAP test is an evenly distributed level of difficulty from easy to medium to difficult. The key is speed. Do not waste time on questions or take more time. Just be very quick.
Okay, so our next question is, how many seats are there for 2017-19 batch? Hello, there are 18 seats for MBA ITBM, 30 seats for MBA DS&DA. Second question is from Vishakha. She says, is there any time limit allotted to any section? No, there is no specific time allotted to any section. It's up to you how you strategize and attempt the paper. And our second question is from Dhruv. How do I practice for SNAP test? Hello Dhruv, you should prepare and practice the syllabus first, then solve previous year question papers, and you can give the mock tests which are online and you can get familiar with the paper style.
Okay, the next question is from Kaushik. Is there any sectional cutoff for SNAP? No, there is no sectional cutoff for SNAP, but every institute will have its own overall cutoff of the shortlisting students. The next question is from Lakshya. What is the eligibility criteria for SNAP test? Graduates from any statutory university or institute with minimum of 50% marks programs which require specific discipline, subjects, specialization need to be checked for eligibility as given by the respective institutes.
Our next question is from Jigisha. When will the result for SNAP test be declared? The result of SNAP 2016 will be declared on January 9, 2017. Our next question is from Krishna. What is the last date for registering for SNAP test 2016? Last date for registering for SNAP 2016 is 22nd November. And the last date for payment is 25th of November, 2016.
Okay, the next question is from Mayur. Is SNAP 2016 an online test or paper-based test? SNAP 2016 is a paper-based test where the students will be given an OMR sheet in which you will be need to mark your answers. The next question is from Karthik. Will the SNAP test be conducted on single day or can we schedule the date of examination? The STEP test will be conducted on a single day, that is 18th of December, and no, you cannot schedule the date.
Our next question is, what is the program pattern for MBA DS&DA? MBA DS&DA is a two-year course with a total of four semester, and industry internship after the first year will happen. Our second question is from John. Will there be any negative marking in the test? Yes, John. Each wrong answer will attract 25% negative score.
The next question is from Arjun. Should the payment be made immediately after enrolling for SNAP test? Yes, payment should be made after registering for SNAP test, but the last date to do so is 25th of November. The next question is from Girija. What is the average package for PGP ITBM course offered at SCIT? Girija, the average package for PGP ITBM is 6.8 lakhs per annum for the 2015-16 batch.
Our next question is from Rohit. What are the topics to prepare for current affairs? Hello Rohit. There are no particular topics to prepare as such. You have to keep track of the last 2 years' current affairs. That would be enough. Our second question is from Ragini. What is the eligibility criteria for NRI students to apply? Hello Ragini. A candidate is eligible to apply as a non-resident Indian if he or she has appeared either for the 10+2 examination or graduation outside India. It is mandatory for one of the two qualifying examinations to be given outside India.
The next question is from Dhaval. What is the eligibility criteria to apply for SNAP? Hi Dhaval, graduate from any recognized university or institute with a minimum of 50% marks, 45% for SC and ST. The programs which require specific discipline subject specialization need to be checked for eligibility as given by the respective institute. The next question is from Niketan. Is the last date of registration for individual college same as SNAP test? No, Niketan. The date for registration of individual colleges depend on each of the colleges, whereas the SNAP test last date will be in December.
Our second question is, how will the final shortlist be calculated? The final merit will be calculated after giving weightages to different scores. Like first is the SNAP score, which will be 50 marks. Second is the personal interview, which will be 30 marks. So third will be the group exercise, 10 marks. And the writing ability test, that is the VAT test, 10 marks. That will be 100 marks total.
Okay, the next question is from Anand. What is the SNAP cutoff score and overall score needed to enroll in the program in accordance to the admitted batch of 2016? Hi Anand, the SNAP cutoff will be decided by the overall SNAP test performance of the current batch and the performance of the applicant who opted for SCIT. The next question is from Jeet. Is there any donation seat available for admissions? No Jeet, every student is urged to note that no donation is required to take admission in Symbiosis, whereas the admission is totally based on your merit and the score which you get in the SNAP test.
Our second question is from Shelja. Is the institute program fee refundable? Hello Shelja. The SNAP registration fees of 1500 rupees and the institute program registration fees of 1000 per program are non-refundable and non-transferable. Second question is from Neeraj. What is the time duration for SNAP test? Hello Neeraj. The SNAP test is an objective test and the duration is 120 minutes.
Okay, the next question is from Sachin. Is there any order in attempting the sections while writing the exam? No Sachin, there is no such order while you are attempting the SNAP exam. You can attempt any section in any order.
Okay, so our second question is from Mukul. Like, when will be the SNAP test results declared? SNAP result will be declared on January 9, 2017. On snaptest.org, available for a month up to February 2017. Second question is from Ishita, is there any donation seat available for admission? No, Ishita, there are no donation seats available. It is totally on your merit list, which will have the results.
The next question is from Zainab. I had made a mistake in filling the form. Will it be a problem if I edit it? Zainab, any changes in the online application form will be entertained only up to the closing date of the registration, which is 22nd of November 2016. No changes shall be permitted after the closing date under any circumstances.
Our next question is, what are the career prospects for MBA, DS&DA? The data analytics is being used not just in IT domains, but other domains such as BFSI, retail, manufacturing, healthcare. And due to the increase in demand for such skills, data analysts and data scientists, many companies are looking for candidates trained in this field.
The next question is from Neha. Neha says, I am a BTech in information technology. I do not like coding. In such a case, is MBA ITBM course suitable for me? I am worried because it is a techno managerial course. Hi Neha, MBA ITBM is not all about coding. You will learn and develop various IT skills, knowledge that is needed to run a business. So there is no need to worry about coding. If you want to pursue your career in IT, MBA ITBM at SCIT is the best course for you.
Our next question is from Sia. How are the placements in SCIT for laterals? Hello Sia. The average package for laterals is 8.4 LPA. For further details about the placement statistics, you may visit the SCIT website. Our next question is from Priyanka. Can you please tell me something more about SCIT? Sure, Priyanka. SCIT is a constituent of SIU, and being a pioneer and leader in imparting education in the niche area of information technology in India, SCIT welcomes those who are willing to take those challenges and transform themselves into a proactive professional. The success of our alumni is a proof to claim that SCIT ensures overall personality development of students who are transformed into industry-ready IT professionals.
The next question is from Raj. What is the maximum package offered last year? Hi Raj, the maximum package offered during the last year batch is 21.33 lakhs per annum. What is the eligibility criteria for taking admissions in SCIT? As said before, graduates of any faculty of any statutory university with 50% marks and 45% marks for SC and ST at any graduation level will be eligible for this course.
Our next question is, will the SNAP test be conducted on single day or we can schedule the date of examination? The SNAP test will be conducted on the single day, that is 18th of December, and no, you cannot schedule the date. Our next question is from Payal. Is it a residential campus or hostels are outside the campus? Hello Payal. For boys, hostel is about 800 meters away in the first year, and in the second year you get a hostel which is inside the campus only, whereas for girls, hostel is inside the campus for both the years.
The next question is from Aditi. What are the topics to prepare for current affairs? Hi Aditi, there are no particular topics which are a mandate to prepare for current affairs, whereas you should keep track of the last 2 years current affairs topics. That would be enough for the exam.
Our next question is from Shaheen. I would like to know the list of subjects for the new data science specialization that SCIT is embarking upon. The data science is a new specialization that SCIT has introduced for this year. We have core subjects, which is common to all the subjects and also the elective subjects. The data science has various subjects, which includes multivariate data analytics, data management, predictive analysis, data mining, social media analysis, and a lot more. You may get the list of specializations on our websites as well.
The next question is from Jai. I'm a fresher BCom graduate with account honors. I'm a little confused about SCIT ITBM. Will it be a good decision as I would be completely new to IT and moreover, how it would affect the final placement process? Hello Jai, it does not affect your final placement process. Just do good while you're in the 2 years of your MBA. You might have to put in some extra efforts, but it won't affect your final placement.
Our next question is SNAP 2016 an online test or a paper-based test? SNAP 2016 is a paper-based test where answers will be marked by the students in an OMR sheet.
The next question is from Ragini. Can anyone explain me what is the difference between MBA ITBM and PGP ITBM? Hi Ragini, PGP ITBM is a full-time one-year residential course for laterals which require a minimum of 18 months of work experience. The focus of this course is on IT security and systems, whereas the MBA ITBM course is a two-year full-time residential course in which various specializations like security, systems, software solutions, IT infrastructure and data science will be provided.
Our next question is from Mohit. Hello Mohit, what is the college hours time and do we have any breaks in the day? And I've heard that hostel for the first year students is outside the campus. Is it true? If yes, is there any gym, swimming pool facility out there? Hello Mohit, the college hour depends on the classes you have in a semester. And yes, the boys hostel is outside the campus for the first year. And from the second year, you will be having the hostel in the campus itself. And yes, we have certain facilities like gym, swimming pool, sports arena for recreational activities.
The next question is from Akhil. What are the topics that are asked for quantitative analysis in SNAP? Hi Akhil, the topics in quantitative analysis include geometry. Under geometry, you'll have lines, angles, triangles, spheres, rectangles, cubes, etc. Then there will be a part on ratio and proportions, which will include percentages in equations, quadratic and linear equations, profit loss averages, time speed distance, work and time, number systems, permutation and combination, and probability will also be a part of this section.
Our next question is from Megha. Will there be any GDPI or only PI for PGP IDPM course? Hello Megha, yes, there would be a group exercise as well as a personal interview, and all the best for your exam. Next question is from Shreya. According to placement statistics, if it says average package for experienced is 8.5 lakhs, so how many years of experience is considered during placements? Hello Shreya, you may refer our website for the same, however 18 plus months of experience is considered as lateral.
Okay, the next question is from Chahat. Hello, could you please update me on the kinds of profile offered by the companies visiting the campus? Hello Chahat, after completing MBA ITBM course, you may be offered with various profiles such as business analytics, quality manager, information security auditor, IT advisor, software architect, big data analyst and many more. Our profiles are aligned with the industry requirements and we offer profiles that are techno-managerial and are essential in the business world today. The next question is from Ramesh. Hello, which institute is better, SCIT, SITM, SICSR? I'm an IT engineer, WorkEx of 1 year. Hi Ramesh, since you are an IT professional, you should go for an ITBM course of SCIT. Your work experience will add extra advantage to the course, and this course will propel your career in the right direction. I'm afraid we cannot comment on the institutes apart from SCIT, but before you make your decision, do take into consideration the scope and the growth of the IT industry sector in India.
Our next question is from Suzanne. What is the ratio of freshers and laterals in SCIT? Hi, Suzanne. The ratio of freshers to laterals is 30 to 70 for the current batch. Our next question is from Ria. How can you tell me more about the hostel life at SCIT? Symbiosis is known for its infrastructure and we provide hostel facilities of the highest standards. Safety and well-being of students is paramount for us. All the needs of students are taken care of and we have a gym and a recreational sports arena also. Besides this, the mess, there is a cafeteria, a juice bar in campus. So don't worry, you'll enjoy the hostel life anyways.
The next question is from Akash. Can you please specify the roles, job roles for data science specializations? Hi Akash, a variety of roles are offered by MBA DS&DA students including data scientist, data architecture, data science consultant, big data analysis, business development, business analytics, market analysts, social network and sentiment analysis,
consumer behavior, health sciences,
behavioral analytics, and business process analysis.
Our next question is from Prajakta. What is the batch size in SCIT? Hello, Prajakta. The batch strength of SCIT as of now is 195 students. And our second question is from Harshal. Can you please let me know the basic guidelines for admissions to SCIT? Hello, Harshal. The student has to appear for SNAP exam, after which the students will be shortlisted and called for the GDPI VAT. And the students clearing the GDPI VAT will be selected to join a batch of 2017-19.
Our next question is from Saloni. She says, what are the events which are conducted in your college? Hi Saloni, there are numerous events held at SCIT from the beginning of the course, which include Samaram, Surya Shibir, Graffiti, which is a flagship event which is held in the month of Jan, Cybersecurity Awareness Month, especially for information security specialization. Also, the events are managed by students. The next question is from Prithvi. Are there any scholarships offered to students of SCIT? Yes, Prithvi, the university provides scholarship to the topper of the first semester, provided the student maintain a CGPA of 7.5 in the following semesters.
Our next question is, when is the last date for payment for SCIT SNAP test? Ideally, payment should be made after registering for SNAP test, but if you haven't already done that, the last date to pay to make the payment is 25th of November. Our next question is, when will be the SNAP results be declared? Hello Akriti, the SNAP results will be declared on January 9th, 2017.
Our next question is from Aditi. What is the SNAP cutoff for SCIT? Hi Aditi, the SNAP cutoff for SCIT for the 2015 and 2017 batch was 31 percentile, whereas the cutoff for this year's batch will be made available soon on our website, which is www.scit.edu.
Our next question is from Ruksan. Does SCIT accepts CAT or ZAT score? No Ruksan, we do not accept CAT or ZAT score, we only accept SNAP scores. Our next question is from Krushal. Do you have any subjects for domains other than IT in your curriculum? Yes, we have subjects in operations, marketing, finance and HR domain as well.
The next question is from Delnaz. Where is the institute located? Delnaz, SCIT is located in Hinjewadi Phase 1, which is the IT hub of Pune. Our institute is flanked by the IT parks on all the sides. We have I2IT campus opposite our campus.
Our next question is from Hitarth. As I'm a fresher, do I need any certifications to get admissions for this course? Hello Hitarth. No, certifications are mandatory for admissions to this course. However, a certification will add weightage to your profile.
The next question is from Naveen. What is the fee structure for data science and data analysis? Hi Naveen, the fees for MBA DS&DA is 6.10 lakhs per annum for the first year and 5.75 lakhs for the second year, which these are subject to changes as per the regulations.
Our next question is, are there any reservations for students at SCIT? Yes, there are certain reservations like SE is 15%, ST is 7.5%. For differently abled person, there are 3% over and above. Total intakes, 2 seats for children of migrants from Jammu and Kashmir Valley, 15% seats for international students as well.
The next question is from Jayant. He asks, what are the different subjects for information security management specialization? Hi Jayant, we offer a variety of subjects for information security specializations that include IT platforms and security, access control, VAPT, computer forensics, cyber intelligence, and many more. The next question is from Nayan. What are the specializations offered at SCIT? Hi Nayan, there are various specializations like information security specialization, secure softwares and solutions specialization, specializations like IT infrastructure management, and also data science.
Our next question is from Forum. Is there any sectional cutoff in SNAP test? No, there are no sectional cutoffs for SNAP test forum. Next question is from Mehak. Does SCIT have tie-ups with any banks for financial assistance for students? Yes, Mehak. We have a tie-up with Credila, Bank of Maharashtra, Syndicate Bank, and Allahabad Bank that have provided educational loans and concessional rate.
The next question is from Farhan. I have a work experience of 6 months. Would it be considered as a fresher or lateral? Hi, Farhan. A work experience of less than 18 months will be considered as a fresher, and work experience above 18 months will be considered as lateral. The next question is from Vijay. Are the graduation marks and previous work experience considered during placements? Vijay, the criteria for placements depend from company to company. If a company has any criteria, then yes, the previous year work experience will be considered. Whereas if the company does not have any criteria, your past graduation marks will not be considered.
Next question is from Rajvi. Hi, I am a BCom graduate. Would MBA ITBM course be beneficial in the long run? Hello Rajvi. It is not necessary for you to be an IT graduate to pursue this course. MBA ITBM course offers a variety of specializations that will be beneficial in the IT industry. Next question is from Erica. Since there is a change in SNAP test structure, can I expect any change in the cutoffs this year? Hello, Erica. The cutoffs entirely depend on the SNAP scores, and we cannot comment on it right now.
The next question is from Naveen. Is there any time limit for each section in SNAP? No, Naveen. There is no particular time limit for each section. But we would advise you to keep track of the time. And speed is the most crucial part, which will help you to score well in your SNAP exam.
Our next question is, will the jobs offered after MBA DS&DA will be in the IT domain only? Hello. The jobs offer won't be restricted to the IT domain. You will find opportunities in BFSI, manufacturing industry, retail and healthcare sectors too.
The next question is from Ruti. Does SCIT provide MBA in distance education? No, Ruti. SCIT provides MBA ITBM course, which is a 2-year full-time residential course. And even our PGP ITBM course is a 1-year residential course. So SCIT does not provide any distance education. The next question is from Raj. I'm a final year of graduation. Can I get admissions in SCIT 2017? Yes, Raj, you can get admissions provided you appear for the SNAP exam and your score is good to be shortlisted for SCIT.
Next question is from Vyoma. Will certificates of extracurricular activities be considered during admissions for SCIT? Hello, Vyoma. Your selection to SCIT will mainly depend on your SNAP score and GDPI. However, any kind of certificates will add weightage to your profile. Our next question is from Vinola. Are there any classes on weekends? Yes, certain classes are scheduled on weekends, and this depends on the electives you choose for your specializations.
The next question is from Arush. I have a 6 months of work experience. Is PGP ITBM a suitable option for me? Arush, you need a minimum of 18 months of work experience to enroll in the course of PGP ITBM. For 6 months of experience, whereas I would suggest you to apply for a ITBM course, which is a 2-year full-time residential course.
Our next question is, what is the process for admissions in MBA DS&DA? The student has to appear for the SNAP exam. After which students will be shortlisted and called for GDPI VAT. The students clearing the GDPI VAT will be selected to join the batch of 2017-19.
Our next question is, what are the job perspectives available for MBA DS&DA? Hi, a variety of job roles are offered for MBA DS&DA. Students including data scientist, data architecture, DS consultant, data analysis, business development, business analytics, market analytics, social network and sentiment analysis, consumer behavior, health sciences, behavior in analytics, and business process analysis.
Our next question is from Kinjal. Is there any medical assistance provided within the campus? Hello Kinjal, Yes, there is a medical center within the campus for any kind of medical assistance you need. Our next question is from Prasen. Is SNAP mandatory for PGP ITBM course? Hello, Prasen. No, SNAP is not mandatory for PGP ITBM course.
Our next question is from Naveen. He says, I'm a fresher and I want to join the DS&DA course. Should I have to do any course for that? Hi Naveen, there is no need to do any special course for MBA, DS&DA. However, it is mandatory for a candidate to have taken mathematics in its 12th standard to join the course of DS&DA.
Our next question is, do I need any certificates to get admissions for this course? Hello? No certifications are not mandatory for admissions to this course. However, a certification will add weightage to your profile.
The next question is, are there any reservation seats for students in SCIT? Hi, there are reservations for SC, which is 15%, ST, which is 7.5%, differently abled, which is 3%, over and above the total intake. 2 seats for children of migrants from Jammu and Kashmir, and 15 seats for international students.
Our next question is, how many general seats are there for MBA, DS&DA? Out of 30 seats for MBA, DS&DA, 22 seats are for general category.
The next question is, what is the process for admissions for MBA, DS&DA? The students have to appear for SNAP exam, after which the students will be shortlisted based on the score, and they will be called for the GE Pivot rounds, which will be held in SCIT. The students clearing the GE Pivot will be selected to join the batch of SCIT 2017 and 19.
Our next question is from Karthik. He says, is there any eligibility criteria for MBA, DS&DA? Yes, Karthik. Graduate of any faculty of any statutory university with 50% marks at graduation level will be eligible. In order to take admission in SCIT, you need to fill the SNAP test form as well as the SCIT form which you'll get online. For MBA, DS&DA, students should have mathematics subjects compulsory in 12th standard.
The next question is, any certification will be covered apart from MBA, DS&DA degree? There will be no certifications covered separately, but you will learn tools such as Python, Hadoop, R, IBM Watson, and many more apart from your DS&DA curriculum.
Our next question is it necessary to have a technical background to opt for MBA, DS&DA? No, graduate from any faculty can opt for MBA, DS&DA as long as he has taken mathematics in 12th science.
The next question is, will MBA, DS&DA contain general MBA subjects or only domain-specific subjects? MBA, DS&DA aims at preparing the student for business and techno-manager functional role. Therefore, a blend of general and domain-specific subject is important. In MBA, DS&DA, subjects like financial management, essentials of marketing, principles and practices of management, managerial economics, strategic human resource management, and corporate governance are also included in the curriculum.
Our next question is from Lavina. I am a student with BA degree. Can I apply for MBA, DS&DA? Hello, Lavina. Yes, you can apply for MBA, DS&DA as long as you have mathematics subjects compulsory in 12th standard.
The next question is, what is the program pattern for MBA, DS&DA? MBA and DS&DA is a 2-year full-time residential course with a total of 4 semesters and industry internship after the first year.
Our next question is, why is mathematics compulsory in 12th standard for MBA, DS&DA? To learn data analytics, students have to be familiar with statistics and algebra, as well as they form the basics for this course. Therefore, it is a mandatory subject.
The next question is from Akash. Which is the best specialization offered in SCIT? Hi Akash, all specializations at SCIT are taught by experienced professors as well as industry experts. We would advise that you choose a specialization as per your interest.
Our next question is from Ujwal. If I apply for MBA ITBM and MBA DS&DA, Will there be a separate GDP PIVAT process for both of this? No, once you're shortlisted based on the SNAP score, you will undergo a single round of GDPIVAT, and the scores of GDPIVAT and SNAP will be used to shortlist those candidates in both the merit list.
The next question is, why is mathematics compulsory in 12th standard for the course of MBA DS&DA? To learn data analytics, students need to be familiar with statistics and algebra, as they form the basics of this course. That is the reason why for the course of MBA DS&DA, mathematics is compulsory in the 12th standard.
Our next question is from Tom. What is the time duration for SNAP test? SNAP test is an objective test, and the duration of SNAP test will be 120 minutes.
The next question is, what are the career prospects of MBA DS&DA? MBA DS&DA data analytics is being used not just in IT domains, but whereas in various domains like BFSI, retail, manufacturing, healthcare, due to increase in demand for skills like data analysts and data scientists, many companies are looking for candidates trained in this field.
Our next question is, what is the difficulty level in the SNAP test? SNAP test has an evenly distributed level of difficulty from easy to medium to difficulty. The key here is the speed, and you should not waste time in questions that take more time to solve.
Our next question is from Harshal. Can you let me know the basic guidelines for admissions to SCIT? Hi Harshal, students have to appear for the SNAP exam, after which the students will be shortlisted based on the score, and the shortlisted students will be called for the further rounds of GE PIVAT, which will be held in SCIT, and the students clearing these rounds will be shortlisted and called for the final admissions to the batch of 2017 and 19.
Our next question is, what is the test structure for SNAP 2016? Hello, there will be 40 questions on general English, which includes reading comprehension, verbal reasoning, verbal ability, 30 questions on quantitative, data interpretation and data sufficiency, 30 questions on current affairs, that will be of last 2 years, and 40 questions on analytical and logical reasoning.
Our next question is, does SCIT accept scores of CAT and SAT? No, SCIT offers only SNAP scores. The next question is, what is the batch size of SCIT? The batch strength for the current batch is 195 students.
Our next question is, what are the career prospects of MBA DS&DA? Data analytics is being used not only in IT domains, but also in domains such as BFSI, retail, manufacturing, healthcare, and various industries. And due to the increase in demand of this skill, data scientist and data analyst, many companies are looking for candidates trained in this field.
The next question is from Akshay. Hi, are there any prerequisites for a DS&DA course? Hi Akshay, the candidates to take admissions for this MBA DS&DA course, you should have mathematics as your primary subject for the 12th standard, whereas apart from mathematics, there are no prerequisites required for this course.
Our next question is from Arjun. Should the payment be made immediately after enrolling for SNAP test? Yes, the payment should be made after registering for SNAP test, but the last date to do so is November, 25th of November.
The next question is, according to the placement stats, it says that average package for experienced is 8.5 lakhs. So how many years of experience is considered during the placements? Hello? According to the laterals, you need 18 plus months of experience to be considered as a lateral. And for any further information for the placement stats, you can refer to our website.
Our next question is, what kind of hands-on tools students will be working on? The curriculum will cover latest software tools by industry standards, and you'll be using tools such as Hadoop, Python, Tableau, IBM Watson, and more as part of MBA DS&DA program.
The next question is, I would like to know the list of subjects for the new data science specialization that SCIT is introducing. Hi, the data science is a new specialization that SCIT has introduced from this year. We have core subjects, which is common to all the students, and also elective subjects. Data science has various subjects, which include multivariate data analysis, data management, predictive analysis, data mining, social media analysis, and lot more. You may get the list of all the specializations and the subjects offered on our official website, which is www.scit.edu.
Next question is, what is the fees for both programs, that is MBA DS&DA and MBA ITBM? Hello, the total fees for MBA ITBM and MBA DS&DA is the same. It is around 10.5 lakhs.
The next question is, can you tell me more about the hostel life at SCIT? Symbiosis is known for its infrastructure. We provide hostel facilities of the highest standards. Safety and well-being of student is paramount. All the needs of the students are taken care. We have a gymnasium, a recreational sports arena. Besides the mess, we also have a swimming pool and a juice center in the campus.
Our next question is from Dhaval. What is the eligibility criteria to apply for SNAP? Graduates from any recognized statutory university or institute with a minimum of 50% marks will require specific discipline, subject specialization need to be checked for eligibility as given by the respective institute.
The next question is it a residential campus or hostels are outside? For boys in the first year, the hostel is outside the campus, which is around 800 meters away from the campus. Whereas in the second year, you will be provided accommodations inside the campus.
Our next question is from Naitik. Is the last date of registration for individual college's name same as the SNAP test? No, it's not the same, as the last date of registration varies for each colleges.
Our next question is, will there be a GE PIVET or PI for PGP ITBM course? Kindly reply. Hello, there will be a group exercise as well as the personal interview rounds for a PGP ITBM course.
Our next question is from Raghav. How do I prepare for verbal reasoning and verbal ability? Hello. You should go through the previous year question papers and you should try to solve as many as mock papers as you can.
The next question is, what is the eligibility criteria for NRI students to apply? A candidate is eligible to apply as a non-residential Indian if he or she has appeared either for the 10th plus 12th examination or graduation outside India. It is a mandate for one of the two qualifying examinations to be given outside India.
Our next question is from Zainab. I had done a mistake in filling the form. Will it be a problem if I edit it? Any chances in the online application form will be entertained only up to the closing date of registration, that is November 22, 2016, and no changes shall be permitted after closing date under any circumstances.
Our next question is the institute program fee refundable? The SNAP registration fee of ₹1,500 and the institute program registration fee of 1,000 per program are non-refundable and non-transferable.
Our next question is from Mukul. When will be the SNAP test results be declared? The SNAP test results will be declared on January 9, 2017 on snaptest.org. And will be available for the month up to February 10, 2017.
The next question is, can I pay cash in any of the banks? Yes, you can select the option of payment through Axis Bank or Indian banks and take the print out of the Axis Bank and Indian Bank challan. This challan has three parts. Pay ₹1,500 in cash at Axis Bank branch in any of your city. The bank will return two parts of the stamped challan to you. One of them is the receipt for you. Sign the stamped Symbiosis copy and pay in slip and send it to the collection center at Symbiosis International University.
Next question is from Raj. What is the maximum package offered last year? Hello Raj. The maximum package offered last year was 21.33 lakhs. And next question is from John. What is the eligibility criteria for taking admissions in SCIT? The graduate of any faculty of any statutory university with 50% marks at graduation level will be eligible. And in order to take admission in SCIT, you need to fill the SNAP test as well as the SCIT form, which you will be getting online.
Our next question is from Amit. He says, as the campus is a bit far from the city, are there any bus facilities provided for the campus? Yes, Amit, there will be bus facilities provided from the campus. Each bus will have different timings, which will take you to the city.
Our next question is from Dhruv. Regarding placements of laterals, can someone guide me? I am worried about its placements as I have to leave a very good MNC to join SCIT in June 2016. Will I get a good job in 2018 after doing my MBA ITBM from SCIT? Hello, Dhruv. Your placements in SCIT is purely depends on how you're performing in these 2 years of your MBA. If you perform well, surely you'll get a placement with good package and with a good role.
Our next question is, will there be a separate GD and personal interview rounds process for MBA ITBM and MBA Data Science and Data Analysis? Yes, there will be a separate process for both these courses. It would be advisable that you book slots for both courses on two different days to avoid confusion. However, if you book both the slots on the same day, arrangements would be made accordingly.
Since this next question is, since this program is newly introduced, will the students be getting placement assistance? Placement assistance will be provided to the students of MBA DS&DA, and interest has been generated for this form among the companies already visiting the SCIT for placements.
The next question is, how do I practice for SNAP test? Prepare and practice the syllabus first. You need to go through the syllabus and the topics which are asked in the previous exams. Solve the previous year question papers, which will be really helpful. And I would suggest you work on your speed, because in SNAP exams, speed is the most important thing. And if you work on your speed, yes, you'll get a good score.
Our next question is from Jay. I'm a fresher BCom graduate with accounts honors. I am a little confused about SCIT ITBM course will be a good decision, as I would be completely new to IT, and moreover, how it will affect in final placement process. Hello, Jay. It doesn't affect your final placements at all. Just do good while you are in the 2 years program, and you might have to put in some extra efforts, but it won't affect the placements at all.
The next question is from Ishita. She asked whether there are any donation seats available for admissions. No, Ishita, there are no donation seats or management quota available at SCIT. The admissions are totally based on your merit performance.
Our next question is, how do I prepare for verbal reasoning and verbal ability? Hello, you should go through the previous year question papers and try to solve as many as mock papers as you can.
The next question is from Alap. Are there any amenities like gym and pool in the campus? Yes, there is a gym and a swimming pool within the campus with experienced trainers. There is also a multi-sports arena in the campus.
Our next question is, can anyone explain me the difference between MBA IT and PGP ITBM? Hello, the PGP ITBM course is a full-time 1 year residential course for laterals that is minimum 18 months of experience. And the focus on this course is on IT security and systems, and you don't get any specializations here.
Our next question is, can you tell me something more about SCIT? Hello, SCIT is a constituent of SIU and has been a major pioneer and leader in imparting education in the niche area of information technology, business management in India. SCIT welcomes those who are willing to take challenges and transform themselves into proactive professionals. The success of our alumni is a proof to claim SCIT ensures overall personality development of students who transformed into industry-ready IT professionals.
Our next question is from Aditya. How many students are placed in the recent year and with what average packages? Hello, Aditya. The last year, 100% of the eligible students were placed, and as per the last year statistics, average package for freshers is 6.6 lakhs and for laterals, the average package is 8 lakhs.
The next question is from Lai. Is there any Wi-Fi and internet facility available in the hostel and campus? Yes, the campus is well equipped with Wi-Fi connection and internet connection ranging from the academic block as well as Wi-Fi connections in the hostels.
Our next question is, could you please update me with the kind of profiles offered by the companies visiting the campus? Hello, Chahat. After completing MBA-ITBM course, you may be offered with profiles such as business analyst, quality manager, information security auditor, IT advisor, software architect, big data analyst, and many more. Our profiles are aligned with the industry requirements, and we offer profiles that are techno-managerial and are essential in the business industry.
Our next question is, what is the college hour timing? Do we have any break of a day in a week? And I heard that hostel for the first year students is outside the campus. Hello, your college timings totally depend on the electives which you've chosen. Various subjects have various timings, and you'll also have classes during weekends, which also depend on the subjects which you've chosen. And yes, for first year, the boys hostel is outside the campus. Whereas you don't need to worry, for the second year, the accommodation for the boys will be provided inside the campus.
Our next question is, if I apply for MBA ITBM and MBA DS&DA, will there be a separate GDP PIVAT process for both? Yes, once you're shortlisted based on your SNAP score, you will undergo a separate round of GD PIVAT, and the scores of GD PIVAT and the SNAP scores will be used to shortlist candidates in both the merit lists.
The next question is, will the college give any assistance for internship? Yes, the internship assistant will be given from the college, and your internship process will be taken care by the college itself, and it will be made sure that you get internship from the college. And the internship will be for 3 months, which will be held in the month of April.
Our next question is from Stuti. Hi, I'm a final year student pursuing engineering through distance learning program. Am I eligible for IT-ITBM at SCIT? Graduates from any recognized university are eligible to apply for SCIT, even if it's a distance education program.
Our next question is, do you have subjects from domains other than IT, or all your subjects are related to IT domain? No, all the subjects offered at SCIT are not related to the IT domain. We have other domains like operations, marketing, finance, and HR domains as well, which will be taught in the curriculum of ITBM.
Our next question is from Delnaz. What is the SNAP cutoff for SCIT? The cutoff was 31 percentile for 15-17 batch, and the cutoff of 16-18 batch will be available later by the authority and will be uploaded online.
The next question is, will certificates of extracurricular activities be considered during the admissions of SCIT? Your selection process at SCIT mainly depends on your SNAP score and how you perform in the SNAP score. But yes, if you have any extracurricular certificates, it will obviously add weightage to your process.
The next question is from Payal. Can you please specify the job roles for data science specialization? Hello, Payal. A variety of roles are offered for data science students, including big data analytics, business development, business analytics, market analyst, business process management, social network and sentimental analysis, consumer behavior, health sciences, behavioral analytics, business process analysis, and many more.
The next question is from Naveen. He says, can you please tell me about the total seats for the MBA ITBM course? Hello, Naveen. For the current batch, there are a total of 195 seats, whereas the seats for the next batch will be updated soon on our website.
Our next question is this program completely developed, designed, and taught by concerned faculties in SCIT, or do you have any tie-ups with a third party delivering different modules? The curriculum will be largely taught by SCIT faculty only, but we have an industry expert associated with SCIT who will be covering few of the courses in different specializations.
The next question is it necessary to have a technical background to opt for MBA, DS and DA? No graduates from any faculty can opt for MBA DS&DA, but provided you have 12, you have mathematics as a subject in your 12th standard.
Our next question is, what are the subjects for information security management specializations? Hello, Jayant. We offer a variety of subjects for information security specializations during IT platforms and security. They are access control and VAPT, computer forensics, cyber intelligence, and many more.
Okay, we hope this webinar was helpful in answering all your queries, and it was a great experience to interact with you all. If you have any more queries, please feel free to reach out to us on the official Facebook page, and also you can post your queries on Pagalgai and Siksha, and also the admission portal of www.scit.edu. Thank you.
Thank you.